This is my faith, this is my focus, all of my days. I know where my hope is, I live it loud, I shout the chorus, because I know, oh, you're always for us. And even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you, I will believe, believe. And even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you, I will believe. And keep on looking, looking, looking to you, for where I'm going, knowing you'll go there too. I'll keep on looking, looking, looking to you, I'll fix my eyes on you. This is my focus, all of my days. I know where my hope is, I live it loud, I shout the chorus, because I know, oh, you're always for us. And even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you, I will believe, believe. And even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you, I will believe. And keep on looking, looking, looking to you, for where I'm going, knowing you go there too. I'll keep on looking, looking, looking to you, I'll fix my eyes on you.
I'm so excited is because I have developed my very own steam lab. Look at it, check it out, check it out, check it out, check it out. Look at, wow. Isn't that so awesome? You're probably wondering what that stands for. Science, technology, engineering, art, and mathematics. And I'm not totally sure how things will go in my lab this summer, but luckily I have faith. Faith is trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see. You see?
You see what I did there?
I have faith that I'll learn a lot and probably have fun doing so. I mean, just look at this place! Check it out.
Whoa!
Oh, wait. Perfect. Check out this microscope! Microscope, 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 microscope! I've always been amazed how microscopes can let you see things that you normally can't see. Take hair, for instance. Ow. Look at that one. See, it looks like a thin line. Mine's kind of curly. Ooh, you can't see it, can you? But put it under a microscope.
Wow.
Cool, right? What about the inside of a piece of grass? Put it under a microscope. Whoa, look at that. The inside looks like a whole bunch of smiley face emojis. I mean, you never see that just by looking at grass. Today's Bible story is all about not being able to see everything, but remembering that God always does. It's like he's always looking through a microscope or something. So, let's take a look at this story and see what we can find. Unbelievable!
Is that really what my hair looks like? Yeah.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Hebrews, chapters 11 and 12.
Gotta have a little faith, faith, faith,
faith. Keep the faith. Take a leap of faith. You know, a lot of people toss around the word faith lately. We say you can break the faith or just take it all on blind faith. But true faith isn't blind at all. It's much more than just an inspirational word. True faith has to do with believing in all the things you can't see because you start with what you can see. Now, we can't see God with our physical eyes, but we can see the stories of people who came before us. They lived in a broken world like we do, but they chose to follow God. They chose to trust his promise that one day he would send a rescuer that would make everything right again. The writer of Hebrews in the New Testament tells us about some of these men and women in God's story. People like Noah, people like Abraham.
Abraham.
When God called Abraham, he was already getting old. He and his wife Sarah didn't have kids.
Leave your country and your people. Leave your father's family. Go to the land I will show you. All nations on earth will be blessed because of you.
God was planning on sending his rescuer as one of Abraham's great, 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 etc. grandchildren. But still, even though Abraham had God's promise, he still couldn't see the one God was sending. Still, Abraham went on a wild adventure, following God's call. And even his descendants, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph, all chose faith in God. Moses, too, was called by God from the fiery heart of a burning bush. Even though he was raised by Pharaoh's daughter, he chose to stand with his own people and face Pharaoh's anger to win freedom. We read about it like this in the book of Hebrews.
Moses suffered shame because of Christ. He thought it of great value.
See, when you check out Hebrews, you discover this huge list of people who followed God by faith. So many that the writer just stops trying to list all of them. Oh, but we can't forget Israel's most important king, David.
Get up and anoint him. This is the one.
Even though God had promised David would be king, though, David spent years on the run from King Saul, fearing for his life. Still, he chose to trust God.
The Lord is my shepherd. He gives me everything I need.
Now, none of these people in the Old Testament could see with their eyes how God was going to save his people, but they could see how he was working in their lives, how their needs were being met. So they chose to believe in his greater plan. They chose faith.
Faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. That is what the people of long ago were praised for.
Now, here's where the story turns. In Hebrews, we discover that none of those people in the Old Testament received what God had promised here on earth.
That's because God had planned something better for us, so they would only be made perfect together with us.
God's plan includes all of us from the very beginning of creation. So at just the right moment, at the perfect point in time, God sent his rescuer, the hero, his very own son, Jesus. Jesus showed us how to live. He showed us what God was like, and he told us the most important thing.
If you love one another, everyone will know you are my disciples.
Love God, love others. It's the heart of the whole story. But then,
Jesus was killed, and his friends thought the story was finished. Period. Dot. The end. Until God raised him back to life. Jesus has defeated death, and those who follow him can live with him forever. But how do you follow someone you can't see? Well, that brings us back to faith.
Let us keep looking to Jesus. He is the one who started this journey of faith, and he is the one who completes this journey of faith. He paid no attention to the shame of the cross. He suffered there because of the joy he was looking forward to. So think about him. Then you won't lose hope.
The early believers, Peter and John and other followers of Jesus, had seen him teach and heal. They saw him after God raised him to life. But after Jesus returned to heaven, the believers continued to live by faith.
We have to speak about the things we've seen and heard.
Because of what the new Christians in the early church had seen, they could believe in what they could not yet see, the end of the story, where God makes everything right. They kept the faith, and because they did, we can choose faith too.
Woo! Take a look at this one. Any guesses on what that is? It's the inside of a carnation stem. It's amazing how things look so different under a microscope than they do just with our eyes. It makes me think of Hebrews chapter 11. It's where we can look back to all these people in history who had faith in God. Even though they couldn't always see how things would turn out, they believed God and his promises. They lived by faith. And you can live by faith too. In fact, having faith in Jesus and what he did for you on the cross is what makes it possible for you to have a relationship with God.
Relationship status update.
Even though we can't see Jesus in person, we can still have faith in him because we can see how he's worked in the lives of the people who've come before us. That's the one thing to remember today. You can know Jesus even though you've never seen him. If you want to know Jesus more and you don't know where to start, try talking with someone who has put their faith in Jesus. Or you can read the stories in the Bible of the people who trusted God long ago. There are lots of things we can see that can help us have faith. So, I hope you guys have an awesome day. I'm gonna look at a few more things under my microscope. Like maybe my nail. Ah, let's check it out. Oh, I need to wash my hands better. This microscope tells you a lot.